Namaste students, welcome back again in the RSV group of YouTube channel. Today we will start our new topic, Crystal Lattice and Unicell. This is the part 4th of the chapter number 1, Solid State. In this video, what is Crystal Lattice and Unicell we have explained. Now starts. What is Crystal Lattice? The regular array of the constituent particles, three-dimensionally inside the crystalline solid. What do you mean by array? The arrangement of the constituent particles. Constituent particles like atom, ions and molecules. किसी crystalline solid में three dimensionally एक regular pattern, एक regular arrangement हो constituent particles का, that is known as crystal lattice. And what is unit cell? The smallest portion which can be repeated in all direction to make a crystal lattice is known as unit cell. Now I have drawn an image for you. Now see this image having 8 cubic unit cells. What is unit cell? The shaded portion of this crystal lattice is known as unit cell because it is the smallest portion of this crystal lattice which make and regularly arrange to make a crystal lattice in the crystalline solids. And the points, these points which are present is known as lattice point. These lattice point having constituent particles. Lattice point kya hai? This lattice point having constituent particles like atom ions. See, it will be explained by an example. See, it is an example NaCl. In NaCl, Na plus and Cl minus ions are formed. So here Na plus ion, then Cl minus ion, then again Na plus ion, representing in the crystal lattice. This Na plus ion coming alternately after the chlorine ion and make a regular pattern in the crystalline solids known as crystal lattice. And the smallest portion is known as unit cells. Now move forward to the characteristics of the unit cell. What is the characters of the unit cell? This is the unit cell. In this unit cell, two characters, two parameters are what? First one is edge length, second one is bond length. What is edge length? The length and the distance between one constituent particle to another constituent particle. यानी दो constituent particle के बीच की दूरी है, उसे हम क्या कह रहे हैं बच्चों? Edge length कह रहे हैं, जिसको हमने किससे denote किया? A, B and C से. In three axes, A, B and C. This is known as edge length. It may or may not be mutually perpendicular. ये mutually perpendicular हो सकता है और नहीं भी हो सकता है. इस तरीके से unit cell अपने अलग-अलग crystal systems में 7 type of crystal systems बनाता है एंड इन 7 टाइप ऑफ क्रिस्टल सिस्टम में 14 टाइप के आपके रिसेस हमें देखने को मिलते हैं. दिस इज नोन एज ब्रेवियस लैटिस. उसके हम क्या कहते हैं बच्चों? दैट इज नोन एज ब्रेवियस लैटिस इन व्हिच 14 टाइप ऑफ सिस्टम्स यूनिट सेल्स आर प्रेजेंट. नाउ अनदर पैरामीटर इज बॉन्ड एंगल, अल्फा, बीटा एंड गामा. Alpha bond angle present in between A and B. Beta is present in between the edge length A and C. And gamma bond angle may form in between the B and C. So this is the basic parameter of the unit cell. Now coming to the types of unit cell. What are the types of the unit cell? How many types of unit cells are here? Primitive and central. There are two types of unit cells which are present, the having the atoms at their corners as well as other positions than corners. The atoms present on the corners which are known as primitive unit cells. It is also known as simple cubic unit cell. Students, it is also known as simple cubic unit cell. In this unit cell, the constituent particles are present only at the corners. See, this is the unit cell. If the constituent particles are present at these corners, and in a unit cell, corners are present. In a unit cell, 8 corners are present. So, the total number of constituent particles are present in the primitive unit cell is 8. That means only present at the corners of any unit cell, that is known as primitive simple cubic unit cell. Another type is centered unit cell. What do you mean by centered unit cell? Constituent particles present at the corners as well as other positions of the unit cell, like we see with the diagram. We say diagram se samajhte hain students. See, this is unit cell. In this unit cell, 8 atoms are present at the corners. 8 atoms are present at the corners. But it is classified in 3 parts. In BCC, 1 atom is present at the center also. One constituent particle is present at the center, and 8 are present on the corners of the unit cell. It is known as BCC, body centered cubic unit cell. In face center, 8 atoms are present at the corners and 6 atoms are present in the 6 faces center. 6 atoms are present on the 6 faces of their center, that is known as face center. मान लीजिए एक आपका क्यूबिक रूम है, उस क्यूबिक रूम में 6 फेस होंगी. उन 6 फेस के अंदर एक तो कॉर्नर्स पे 8 एटम्स प्रेजेंट है ही उस क्यूब के अंदर, और हर फेस की जो सेंटर है, जैसे मान लीजिए फेस 6 है तो 6 के सेंटर, तो टोटल कितने हुए 6 फेस सेंटर्स और 8 कॉर्नर्स के एटम्स. नेक्स्ट वन इज एंड सेंटर. व्हाट डू मीन बाय एंड सेंटर स्टूडेंट्स? एंड सेंटर क्यूबिक यूनिट सेल मींस 8 constituent particles are present at the corners as well as 2 atoms are present in the opposite faces center. 2 atom aapke dono face ke opposite face ke center par present honge, use hum kya bolenge? End center bolenge. 8 are present at the corners and 2 atoms are present on the opposite faces, like this opposite face, also like this opposite face. This is known as end centers. And also another type of centered unit cell is present, that is known as edge center. That is known as edge center. What do you mean by edge center? Students, you know that this is the unit cell. In this unit cell, how many edges are present? Students, I am explaining you, in between the two constituent particles, edge length is present. This edge length having 12 centers, because 12 edges are present, so the edge centers are 12 and 8 are at the corners. So number of atoms present in the edge center is 12 atoms are at the edges and 8 atoms are at the corners of the unit cell. So this is the main basic part of the crystal lattice and unit cell. Thank you.